huge team producing this cosplay contest. Lots of volunteers helping out, and we are ready and set to go. Contestants are in the back, contestants are backstage, everybody's set. But first, let me go ahead and run through everything that we do. Today we have a new announcer, Chance LaPrey. Join me up on stage. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Chance. He will be announcing all of the names, the characters, the categories, all that stuff. Chance, please go ahead and let the crowd know what you do and what you're about.
Nice to meet you all. It's great to be up here, and I'm extremely excited to offer my voice to this show. I have been producing with my team the first official FanX Quest this entire time.
Give it up, give it up, give it up if you participate in the quest.
All Around You has been an interactive game and story without you even knowing. And so next year, with plenty of great feedback, hopefully we'll be bringing back a bigger and better experience to you that you could not even believe.
Bigger and better in 2022. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Chance. Thank you so much. Chance is going to be helping us out. He's getting ready. He's going to read off the judges' bios. Of course, with any competition, this is what had to happen. We got hundreds of entries into the contest. We only have a limited amount of time in this big stage, in this ballroom. So everybody went through a preliminary round. Online judging took place. The top scores moved on into the contest. This very morning, all of the contestants went in front of the judges. They got seen in person. Every stitch, every seam, every warp, every foam, it all got scored and critiqued in front of them, okay? So they go ahead and add those scores to tonight's stage performance scores, and then you have the total of who is best at FanX. Does that make you guys happy? Does it? Yes! Let's go ahead and meet some of the amazing, talented judges that are going to be judging this year's cosplay contest winner. Chance, who is the first judge that is up?
First judge that you have the pleasure of meeting is Alex Heater. From Ethereal Plane Creative Workshop, aka EPC Workshop on Instagram, is a costume designer technician. Alex brings 8 years of cosplay and costume experience to the judging table. He has worked for stage theaters such as TourCon, Utah Festival Opera, and several productions at Utah State University. Alex is obsessed with careful details and authentic materials. He even picked up blacksmithing and armor smithing to beef up his knowledge base and give all his cosplays that authenticity and wow factor.
Give it up for Alex, everybody! Wait. Before we continue, Alex, tell us about that jacket, because I know you just bought it off the rack, right?
No, I did not. I actually try not to buy the cosplay things. Guys, the best part about cosplay is making it, right? And also looking awesome. You guys look amazing. No, I actually, when I first started in cosplay, a friend of mine who was an insanely talented seamstress took me under her wing, took me to my first convention, and helped me make this so I wouldn't feel stupid. And so, thankfully to her, she's no longer with us, but she helped me make this wonderful jacket, and I'm just so glad it still fits.
Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Alex. Woo! So awesome, so awesome. Next up, who do we have, Chance?
Next up, Jeremy L. Byrd. Don't let the name fool you. Jeremy is a true Renaissance woman. She is accomplished artist, designer, master craftsman, creative consultant, entertainment designer, scenic artist, sculptor, and muralist. Well known for concept design, she's an award-winning master prop builder, hair and makeup artist, stage set and costume designer slash builder, a mother of five, grandmother of 10, and mama bird to more kids than she can even count. Jeremy is also a published children's book author, writer and illustrator of the children's book series, The May Encounters of Bosley Bear. The Many Encounters of Bosley Bear. Most recently, Jeremy has taken her talents and her passion for kids and, along with her daughter, founded the Figmentation Foundation, a nonprofit who works with kids suffering from a life-altering illness or injury to reawaken their innocence and childhood wonderment by transforming their figment of imagination into their unique hero's journey, then put it on the big screen.
Wow, give it up, give it up, give it up. Jeremy, one of the things that caught my ear is a grandmother of 10, right? How many grandkids do you have?
10.
That is amazing on its own right. The next thing that I heard is about the Figmentation Imagination, the MPO. Tell us more about that.
The Figmentation Foundation is a nonprofit organization that helps kids that have a life-altering illness or injury. And what we do is we take their little imagination and we turn it into a movie and make them the star in their own hero's journey. It's awesome.
Amazing. Thank you so much, Jeremy. That is incredible. Give it up for cosplay in the community. Chance, I believe we have another judge. Who is it?
Skylar Osler, AKA the Cosplay Apprentice. With his foam smithing tutorials on YouTube and his line of cosplay products, his goal is to help you to confidently create spot cosplays that will stand out online and on the con floor.
Skylar, amazing! Okay, that glove, give it up. What's the story behind that?
All right, this is what I call the ultimate crafting gauntlet, okay? So here, can you hold the microphone for me, please? All right, so what it's got, if you guys can see this on camera here, I've got all my pens, pencil, markers. I have a different color for marking the foam for each type of technique I'm using so that I can keep track of everything. Right here, I've got a soft measuring tape right on the back of my wrist. Pops back in. And then I've got my glove in case I'm working with any hot things. And then one of the best parts is this flips open and you have a notebook on the inside to be able to write down notes and things.
Genius.
I actually have a tutorial on exactly how I made this in a free pattern on my YouTube channel on Cosplay Apprentice on YouTube. So you can check that out. You can make one of your own and get crafting, my friends.
Give it up to Skylar, everybody. Amazing. Amazing. I'm gonna wait to go on that merch store and just purchase one of those. I will. Hey, Chance, last but not least, I hear we have one more judge for this year's cosplay contest.
Rounding out our quartet of talents, Travis Heisel. Travis Heisel is a 2018 addition to the FedEx Cosplay Hall of Fame and the founder of the Legacy Initiative, a charity group that has drawn attention at the local and national level for their work. Their homeless outreach program has drawn much attention and has been widely praised. Travis is an avid member of their cosplay team. This team serves children living with life-threatening illness and or poverty, those with developmental disabilities, the elderly, community events, and other nonprofits. Travis is a lifelong maker and learner. He enjoys working in a variety of mediums, and he wears a great cape.
That is amazing. Give it up for Travis. Travis, a little bit about that suit. Tell us what it is and how you made it.
This was essentially a one-day crunch build. Sometimes cosplays don't go as planned, and the build that I was neck deep in just wasn't gonna happen. So with the help of my significant other, we threw this thing together.
He says he threw that thing together overnight. That is amazing. Travis, thank you so much. Judges, please go ahead and take your seats over there at the front. Travis, I'm gonna hold on tight to you for a second. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for these three judges right there. Before we get to our contestants, one last thing. One of the amazing aspects of FanX Cosplay is that we have so many cosplayers just like Travis and all the other judges right there that are doing so much with cosplay in our community. That goes along with what we went ahead and created at FanX, something called the Cosplay Hall of Fame. That is where we highlight specific cosplayers that are doing good in our communities. They're tied into charities, they do volunteer work, they spread the message of cosplay to everybody out there, and they try to do something positive along with it. Does that sound awesome to you guys? Yeah? Excellent. Perfect. Let's go ahead and highlight some of those peeps. Cosplay Hall of Fame, where are you at? Let me see ya. Scotty, can we get some party music up in this house, please? Let's go ahead and get something a little bit bumping. Thank you so much, sir. Come on through. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for your FanX Cosplay Hall of Fame. Just a little bit because, hey, give a quick introduction about yourself and what you're associated with.
I am part of Heroic Utah, which is a local charity cosplay group. We do hospital visits, visits to Ronald McDonald House, other organizations where they need costume heroes to raise awareness or to help raise funds.
Hello everyone, I'm Chandra. I am the latest inductee into the Hall of Fame. I was inducted in 2019. I am a professional cosplayer who appears at festivals around the world. I also work with a couple of 501c nonprofits such as Millie's Princess Foundation, Mascot Miracles, the Tim Tebow Foundation, etc. And it is such an honor to be with all of you today. So thank you for coming.
My name is Robbie Damewood. I was inducted in 2017. I am part of the Rebel Legion and the 501st Star Wars cosplay charity groups. I've helped with raising money for Make-A-Wish, Ronald McDonald House, various others, visits to Primary Children's Hospital and others that need a Star Wars character to give some help.
I'm Travis Heisel. I'm the 2018 addition to the Hall of Fame. I'm with the Legacy Initiative. We do much the same as the other groups, hospital visits, care centers, community events, anything nonprofit really. We love working with other groups. And we pride ourselves in being radically inclusive and helping new and upcoming cosplayers that join our team to become the best that they can be.
Ladies and gentlemen, please give it up. Awesome cosplayers, Cosplay Hall of Fame. Thank you so much. Have your seat either at the judges' table or backstage as we go ahead and prepare all the novices. Hey, my backstage crew, make sure you got the novices ready to go. Novice category is coming up. Novices are taken to the stage. Judges are getting logged in. No problem, no worries. I'm gonna go ahead and do a little thing that Chris always likes to go ahead and do with people, yeah? Whenever you come into the ballroom, you gotta play some of his games. So this is what we're gonna do. Before we get to the contestants, I'm splitting the room in half. This side, you have to say cause. This side, when I point to you, you say play. Let's practice. Cause. Play. Oh, good, good. Excellent. We are going to see which side is the loudest. Practice again. Cause. Play. Okay, but you got to go ahead and look at your neighbor next to you. You have to go ahead and get him into it, okay? Here we go, for real. I'm going to keep pointing back and forth. We're going to see which is the loudest side. Ready? This side. Cause. This side. Cause. They're gonna give me the thumbs up when they're ready to go. Thank you again one more time for being a part of 2020 FanX Cosplay. The judges are doing their thing. Scott's gonna give us a little bit of jams as we go ahead and get ready, get prepared. Remember, we divide this cosplay contest up by difficulty. We have our novice category, we have our intermediate category, we've got our group category, and of course we have our master's category. At the very end, we are gonna give awards to third, to second, to first place in each category. After that, we're gonna give some judges special awards, judges' choices, and at the very end of tonight, we're gonna go ahead and see who the best is by giving them the best in show and a total of $5,000. Does that sound okay? Yes? Yes? Perfect. That's what we love to hear. Because at FanX, we understand whether you're a kid, whether you're an adult, whether whatever it is, cosplay is for everybody. Eric's giving me the thumbs up. Novices are backstage and they are getting ready. Chance is ready to go ahead and announce. He gives me the thumbs up. Ladies and gentlemen, one more time, give it up for cosplay! Your 2021 contestants start right now!
001, Amy Shaw, Jawa and Goth Droid. N006, Kana Story, Ciri from Witcher 3, The Wild Hunt. N008, Jessica Bivakwa, Bevy Cosplay, Cade 6.
Look, I know you're new, so let me catch you up. Everything you love about Earth is gone. Your skinny no-foam vanilla latte? Gone. Binge watching? Gone. Card. My son, the Grand Canyon? Ruined. Okay, that didn't change much. But say goodbye to surprise parties, ketchup and mustard, late night texts, Taco Tuesdays, and if that wasn't enough, puppies or
not the puppies.
I know, right? Just that. I mean, I'm more of a cat guy, but still, where was I? Everything is gone, except for the last city. And now, a psycho rhino named Gaul has come to take that away too. So it's time to bring out the big guns. And the ramen shops. Do it for the loot they've taken from us. But most importantly, do it for the puppies!
N009, Jennifer Lee, Elder Scrolls Online inspired, The Fancy Nord. Hufferson Haddock.
Thank you.
7, Logan Pierce, the Cosmonger, a junkyard gladiator design out of his own inspired mind. Simon Near Automata. Alien Xenomorph.
We better get back, because it'll be dark soon, and they mostly come at night. Mostly.
Time's up. Get off the stage.
Nicki Minaj, Glam Rock Freddy. Edelgard, Fire Emblem Three Houses. N026, Gerald Brady, Buzz Lightyear.
Oh yeah, me too. I remember him.
N042, Heidi Schofield, Tanjiro Kamado. Dark, Happy Masked Salesman.
Oh, you've met with a terrible fate, haven't you? Yeah.
N048, Emmy Lou Cosplay, don't call him short, Edward Elric! N049, Matthew Payne, get your assault rifles ready, Master Chief! N060, Tamara Lynn cosplays the Queen of the Nile herself, Cleopatra.
All hail Cleopatra, kindred of Horus and Ra, beloved of the moon and sun, daughter to Isis, and of Aqua Lord Egypt, Queen.
Hedera Kaz, Zelda from The Legend of Zelda, Twilight Princess. N064, Rachel Reynolds, crossing the no man's land, Wonder Woman! N065, Derek Reynolds,
the Prince of Asgard, Thor! N068, Sidewalk Bird Cosplay, Pepper Potts Endgame Rescue Iron Man Suit. N072, Gumi from Echo.
Pose it, click it, cross it, crack it, twitch, update it, name it, read it, tune it, print it, scan it, send it, fax, rename it, touch it, bring it, pay it, watch it, turn it, leave it, stop, format it, buy it.
And rounding out our novice category, careful reminder, please keep your cheers as loud as you can, but keep the whistles to a minimum or zero. For this next up is N074, Just Misty Quiet from Metal Gear Solid 5.
Feels every everything, right? Judges, are you liking what you see him? Yep, Eric, everybody else, yes, judges, excellent, cool. Are you ready for a couple of our groups, judges? Yep, couple of the groups coming up. They're deliberating, they're chatting about what they're gonna eat afterwards. I get it, I'm hungry too, but guess what? More awesome cosplay coming up, right? Hey, if you didn't know, we're streaming live on FanX.tv as well at the same time, so everybody that couldn't be here today is also seeing this. As soon as they get the thumbs up from the judges, we're going up for the groups. So this is what we're doing a little bit different this year. We're sprinkling some groups in between each and every single category. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for your first batch of group cosplay. Give it up, give them a welcome.
01, Rhonda Guevara, Plague Doctors. G002, Dana Beth Bernardo.
Welcome to the Mighty Nine. So we met at like a circus. It's a crazy night. But after a while, yada yada. I guess in a way I'm an orphan maybe too.
I was trying to do the thing, like I killed my family, I'll throw you under a bridge. I've always heard that the best way to deal with your problems is to run away from them.
Yeah, 60 seconds, but I have more knuckles.
When your body is your weapon, everything needs to be in tip-top shape.
You don't need to talk anymore. You need me. More than I need you. I am the Empire, but I am no friend to the Empire.
Maybe heroes that no one knows about, but we know.
G003, Midlife Mom Play, Nike, Persephone, Ibris. G004, Prue, Queen of Hearts.
first set of group. We're done with the novices. We've touched a little bit on groups. Judges, we're gonna head over to our intermediate category. Give me the thumbs up when you're nice and ready. That's a nice sign, right? Exactly. Cool. FanX 2021, are you ready to see your intermediates? Make some noise. Excellent. Chance, go.
I-001, Cast B Cosplay, Achilles from Hades. I-006, Hermione Hatch, Elton John at Dodger Stadium, circa 1975.
Elton John to stage. Elton, Hercules John, Dodger Stadium waits for no one.
Before I will fight the fight and win the war.
la, da 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 da.
I-013, keep your eyes to the ramp. Carly Webster, Sam Jubilee Webster, Mecha Team Leader. I-014, Garnet Banzai, Luke from the Adventure Zone.
I know you don't say this enough, but thank you. That was the last conversation you ever had with your sister. When someone leaves your life, those exits are not made equal. Some are beautiful and poetic and satisfying. Others are abrupt and unfair. But most are just unremarkable, unintentional, clumsy. Where Luke went, she didn't intend to end up there, and she certainly didn't intend to spend as much time away as she did. But from your perspective, Luke was there, and then the next day she wasn't. And you all searched for her, but she was nowhere to be found. And all you had to go on was a note, and its two-word message offered no clues to her whereabouts, but simply a promise that was left unfulfilled. Back soon.
I-016, Winter Star Cosplay, Scarlet Witch.
Scarlet Witch.
your eyes back to the ramp for I-019 Whisper Ra Stargate. Your mom cosplay, Caitlin from League of Legends. I-021, Ellie Finnegan, Franziska von Karma. Rounding out the intermediate category, I-022, Gentle Sunflower, White Pearl.
Echoes left and right, she had a scream that could crack the walls. She didn't mean to hurt me.
You were hurt, badly hurt.
But she didn't mean to.
G009, Jared and Cheryl Moser, Zelda and Link from Breath of the Wild. We need disguises cosplay, Kingdom Hearts of the Caribbean.
Yo ho, yo ho, a pirate's life for me.
What's that? What is that?
G015, Jillian Whiteley, bring your crowns and capes for superhero princesses. Dusty and Corbin Anderson, Hawkeye and Loki!
Thank you.
your novices, we've been through your intermediates, we've been through your groups. It is time for the most difficult category. I see you right there. That was clapping right there. I saw that. Your master's category. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for those masters!
Master 002, Suvi on the ramp with Toothless. Put your wings together for Hawkman. Barnum, Autobots roll out, it's Bumblebee!
Yeah.
009, we need disguises cosplay with Agatha from Legend of Zelda Twilight Princess. Liana cosplay with a Victorian Lady Loki. Put your eyes to the ramp for Master 012, Lady Dowdle, let's take a ride on a chocobo. If a chocobo starts limping, I hope the same thing doesn't happen with horses. Master 013, back on the ramp, necessarily Broadway Ursula.
Now I got a voice. The boss is on a roll. You poor unfortunate.
015, Bjorn Enderley.
My name is Bjorn Enderley, and you are in love with me.
For our last master, Master 018, Hannah Sweden with Springtrap from Five Nights at Freddy's.
You got this.
Kids, it's just so amazing. Thank you so much. Are you ready?
We can do it. Are you ready? Okay, let's start for this first.
Everybody who visited the booth has a chance of winning this first prize. She's shaking it up or showing us her best dance moves.
You don't have to be present to win. If you're not here tonight and I pull your name, we will make sure that you get your gift. All right, here we go.
Thank you.
Ethan Hyman!
Ethan Hyman, where are you at? Ethan, make some noise. Where are you at? Where are you at? Where are you at?
Here?
Raise your hand. Show me your best dance moves. Come on down. Ethan is not in the house.
Not here? Okay, hey, Ethan's
dude,
not in the house.
Bad time to go on a bathroom break, bro. Serious. Come get your prize.
Okay, for the adult shield and sword.
The double pack. You're not just on defense this time. Defense and offense. Woo! Shield and sword combo. We're gonna see who the winners are. Open that box up. Shake it, shake it, shake it, shake it, shake it. I like how our ASL interpreters are saying shake it, shake it, shake it, shake it. Who we got, Jamie? Who we got?
Our winner is Copeland Fowkes. Copeland Fowkes.
Copeland, are you in the house? Copeland, where are you at?
Copeland Fowkes.
Anyone pretending to be Copeland? No.
Okay, no Copeland Fowkes.
We'll make sure. We'll make sure Copeland gets it. Copeland's getting it. One last one, Jeremy.
Okay, the last one.
I don't.
The child's shield.
Child shield. Child sword. And I never thought I'd say this, but the Lynch King is going to pick today's winner. Yeah! Woo! Anything happens at Fan X. Jeremy, who we got?
Okay, we've got...
Hard name to pronounce, I get it.
It's McEnroe. Michael McEnroe.
You are a doctor for sure. You got that writing. Michael McEnroe, come over here, over to the ramp to go ahead and claim your prize. Yeah, Michael, is he right there? See, somebody faking it.
Is he here?
No, Michael. Okay, that's all right. They still get their prizes, right?
Okay, they still get their prizes.
That is amazing.
Hey, thank you guys and everybody that participated.
Everybody, thank you so much.
Awesome.
Give it up for Pigmentation, Imagination, Jeremy Lindberg, everything that she does. And ladies and gentlemen, one more time for the Lynch King at Fan X.
Thank you so much for all your support for Pigmentation Foundation. Please go to pigmentation.org and help support it. It's a great organization. Thank you.
Perfect. Thank you so much, Jeremy. We'll make sure we'll get some extra hands. No worries about that. Ladies and gentlemen, we will have your winners in just a couple of minutes. Right now, they're getting picked over there in the back. We're gonna go ahead and take them on back. You're gonna see who is the best in novice, intermediate, who masters, groups, and of course, our best in show. Are you ready for your winners? Excellent, there we go. Chance, who is our third place in the novice category?
Third place in our novice category goes to N010, Brenna Bateman, with Astrid Hopperson Hunt.
Give it up, give it up. There we go. Hey, take a bow right there. There we go. Third place novice. Let's go. Perfect, perfect, perfect. Congratulations. Chance, who do we have for second place?
Coming in at rank two is novice 060, Tamara Lynn Cosplays as the Queen of the Nile, Leo Pasqua.
There we go, just like that. Chance, who do we have for first place?
Your number one rank, novice category, is novice 013, Ken Sullivan as the alien Xenomorph.
For sure. Ladies and gentlemen, third, second, first place novices, give it up for your novice category. memories forever. Hashtag magic moments. Thank you guys so much. Down the ramp. Down the ramp. There you go. Thank you so much, novices. Your awards are coming with you. Excellent. Hey, give it up for these awesome volunteers right here. Volunteers. That's it for your novices. I feel so happy. But now, Chance, I believe intermediate is up next, right?
That is absolutely correct, bro.
Perfect. Who do we got up? Third place intermediate.
Third place intermediate category goes to I-019, Chantel Bryson, aka Whisper from Raw with Stargate.
Woo! Gentlemen, one more time. Woo! So amazing. So incredible. Perfect. Chance, I believe there's more. Second place, intermediate, who is it?
Rank two for intermediate is I-007, Trickster King cosplay as King George III.
Second place intermediate, everybody, give it up one more time. Next round of applause. Excellent. Chance, give me first place in their intermediate category 2021 FanX Cosplay Contest.
First place for your intermediate category goes to I-006. Bust out your peanuts and Cracker Jacks for Hermione Hedge with Elton John at Dodger Stadium.
Category winner! Thank you so much. Down the ramp, you'll get your awards. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Right down there. Perfect. Thank you, guys. We're gonna scoot all the way off. Perfect. Hey, and this is some of our staff right here. Chelsea, Carly, Adam, wave and give them a high five. Make some noise for them. So amazing.
Groups categories up next.
Give it to me, Chance. Third place groups, let's go.
Third place goes to G015, Jillian Whiteley, Jillian and Reagan Whiteley, Belle Jepsen for the Superhero Princesses. G001, Rhonda Guevara for the Plague Doctors.
Make some noise, FanX. Let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go. Second place to FanX groups, everybody. Second place. Awesome. Last but not least, Chance, first place in groups, give it to me.
The first place in the group category goes to G004, Prue. Let heads roll for the Queen of Hearts.
Let's go, everybody. there, go for it. They got the prize money, they got the awards, they got the medals. Super amazing and awesome. Velma was just up here helping us out with our production of cosplay this year. K-Chance, what's up next? She's not done yet, folks. Chance, what category is up next?
The big one, Master Category.
Masters, third place. Who is it, Chance?
Everyone keep your eyes on the ramp. Rank 3 goes to Master 002, Suvi for Toothless.
Ladies and gentlemen, third place Master, let's go! Love it, love it, love it! Chance, second place Masters, please.
Second place Masters goes to Master 009. We need disguises cosplay for Agatha from Twilight Princess. Woo!
Robbie Damewood with the awards. I love it. Chance, first place, Masters category, 2021 FanX Cosplay Contest. Tell us.
Your number one for your master class is Master 008, Becky Barnum. Autobots, roll out. It's Bumblebee!
Is watching us from home right now, right? She wasn't a part to be here, but we love Mariel. If you're watching this, we miss you so much. She's also in our Hall of Fame for cosplay. We got Eric, we got Robbie, we got Miss Shauna right there. Travis was judging. Hey, while they go ahead and make their walk, remember we're not done. We have Judges' Choice Awards and the Best In Show coming up. We're getting through this. Chance, who's up next?
The first category is storytelling, because this is gonna be a story to see.
Storytelling. One second. Giving everybody an opportunity to do that. Mr. Travis H. Izzy is all the way up here. Chance, who takes home this award?
For storytelling, judge's choice. G003, Midlife Mom Play, Nike, Persephone, and Iris. Give it up for your guys.
Thank you so much. Right over here. Right over here. Chance, which Judge's Choice Award is up next?
Next up is Needlework.
Needlework. Perfect. Give it up for Mr. Alex right there. With the awards, another judge. Who is the winner of Best Needlework in the competition?
The Judge's Choice for Needlework is G013. It's a pirate's life for me, folks, because it's the Kingdom Hearts of the Caribbean!
Yes! Let's go! Let's go! Incredible. Chance, I believe we have at least one more, right?
We do have one more category, and that goes to armor.
Kingdom Hearts. Out of all the cosplays, why this one?
We just really love the game. Honestly, it's like one of our favorite games. Who's a Kingdom Hearts fan out there?
Kingdom Hearts fans, let's go. Excellent. Love it. That's amazing. Do you concur? Do you agree?
I totally agree. 100%.
Good answer. Good answer.
All right.
Chance. Perfect. Let's go, Chance.
Best armor craft goes to N020 Camry Mon for Edelgard from Fire Emblem Three Houses.
Skylar is here with their award. It's all right. We're going to go ahead and give it to him after. Thank you so much. Give it up for your Judges' Choice Award. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Last but not least, this is how we wrap up the night in this room and FNX. The best. I get the feels too. I get the feels too, especially after our long break. First and foremost, thank you so much to everybody in attendance. Please, round of applause for all the awesome volunteers that helped make this show. We got media team, we've got staff, we got friends from out of state visiting us this time around. We have awesome AV. We have everybody and anybody helping this out. Why? Because FanX is created by community. To everybody that had a hand in this, please give it up one more time for everybody helping make this show a success, including yourself. ASL interpreters, I'm looking your way. Yep, yep, yep. Last but not least, Chance. For $5,000, who is the best in show?
The moment you've been waiting for. Your best in show for FanX 2021, Master 013. Necessarily, she'll steal your voice.
Any way you want to. One more time, ladies and gentlemen, give it up for the cosplayers.